Okay, as we all know, whenever we have a quadratic equation, we can just use the quadratic formula or to complete the square, and we'll end up with this for the answer. But have you guys ever thought about what if we have a congruence right here instead? And yes, this right here is a quadratic congruence, and I've talked about this in the mod 7 world. In this case, what can we do? Well, I'll show you guys two ways to do this. First of all, I want to point out that this right here is not that bad, but we still have to do it carefully. Imagine if you have a mod 6, right? If this number is not prime, let's say mod 6, for example, that's going to be so much more detail being involved. So, you know, that's harder. Maybe next time. But anyway, as I said, I will show you guys two ways to do it. First, well, unfortunately, we cannot factor this yet. And you'll see what I mean by that later. So I will just deal with this as how it is. I will not use the quadratic formula. I will complete the square. So let me just add 1 on both sides, and I get x squared plus 2x, and I will leave a space, and this is congruent to positive 1 mod 7. And now, this right here is, you know, the matching number place. First of all, be sure that you have a 1 in front of the x squared, which we do. Next, look at the coefficient of x, which is 2. Take half of that, half of 2 is 1, and square that, 1 squared is still 1, and you are going to add a matching number here, and then, of course, do it on both sides. This right here is so magical because the left-hand side is the perfect square now, and you can factor it, x plus 1 times x plus 1, right? You know, this is x plus 1 square, and then, of course, on the right-hand side, 1 plus 1 is 2. This is very nice, and then you have mod 7 right here. Imagine if this was an equation, you will just go ahead and square both sides and then put a plus minus and then minus 1 on both sides and you end up with that. That's pretty much it. But this is a congruence. With that said, you are going to find integer solutions for congruences. X has to be an integer. If you take the square roots on both sides, it doesn't really make much sense, right? Square root of 2 cannot do. 2 is not a perfect square. But this is the first thing you have to be careful. In the mod 7 world, what you are going to do is, you can actually go from 2 and just keep adding 7. 2 plus 7 is 9. So the idea is that 2 is congruent to 9 mod 7. They have the same remainder when you divide them by 7. And 9 is a perfect square. That's what we like. Therefore, I will look at this. As I tell you, I will just look at this as 9. And then, of course, I will still put on a mod 7, and then the left-hand side is still x plus 1 squared. And then from here, you can take the square root on both sides, but you have to be really careful. We can do it because we have this powerful green marker. Well, you have to know that 7 is prime, and this right here is in my previous video. When you have something square, it's congruent to a number. If you have to take the square root on both sides, you have to make sure this right here is prime. Well, 7 is prime, that's good. That's why I said if it's a 6, then unfortunately we cannot do that. So in this case, this is okay because it works in this case. Well, here we have x plus 1 is congruent to the first situation is positive 3. Right, square root of 9 is positive 3, and then mod 7, and then the other situation, x plus 1, is congruent to negative 3 mod 7. And then we'll just solve this and that. Minus 1 on both sides, x is congruent to 2 mod 7. So that's the first answer. And then the other one, minus 1 on both sides, x is congruent to negative 4 mod 7. So that's pretty much it. But usually you want to keep this as positive as possible. So what we can do is go from negative 4 and then you add 7 to it and you end up with positive 3. So I will tell you x is congruent to positive 3. And of course, let's put on the mod 7. So we have two answers. X is congruent to 2 mod 7 and also x is congruent to 3 mod 7. That's it, right? Pretty cool, because as you can see, originally, this equation, the answers were irrational. And now, in the congruence world, you actually end up with, you know, really nice answers, right? And again, 2 is not the only answer. You can just keep adding 7 or keep subtracting 7. So the idea right here is that x is in the form of 2 plus 7k, and you have to indicate where k is integer. Similarly, x is in the form of 3 plus 7k. Well, I use k over there already, so perhaps I'll use l. So I'll just say l is an integer. So for example, if you use, let's say, 10, because 3 plus 7 times 1 is 10. You put it here, 10 squared is 100, 100 plus 20, right? And that's 120, and then minus 1 is 119. Divided by 7, you have no remainder, so try it on your own, right? Okay, so that's the first way, and the trick is right here, right? If you have a number right here, if this right here has a solution, you have to really make sure, okay, just think about how to produce a perfect square so you can take the square root of that and all that. But the deal is that, in fact, this right here, it's actually factorable. Let me show you how. So, second way is the one that you guys will really like. Let me write down x squared plus 2x minus 1 is congruent to 0 mod 7. So here's the deal. You have three terms right here, and the truth is you can keep adding 7 or keep subtracting 7 to the coefficients or the constant term, all right? And as long as it works, it works. So here's the deal. What I will do is I'll look at negative 1, subtract 7, which becomes negative 8. And I'll look at this as x squared plus 2x. Because this was not factorable, but once you see I subtract 7 from here, you get negative 8. This is congruent to 0 mod 7. Now, look at this right here, this quadratic expression. Can we factor it? Yes, very nice. So we'll just factor it. This right here, if you factor, you get x plus 4 times x minus 2. And of course, this is congruent to 0 mod 7. Well, don't be so happy. This right here, it's easy because, again, 7 is prime. So here's the deal. When you have this times that is congruent to 0 mod 7, what that means is that 7 divides this or 7 divides that, right? 7 divides this or 7 divides that because 7 is a prime. You guys can check out my other videos for the proofs. And right here, I will just tell you, because of that, I can say x plus 4 is congruent to 0 mod 7, and then the other one is x minus 2 is congruent to 0 mod 7. If that was a 6 right here, mod 6, then cannot do this, right? By the way, here is easy now because you can just minus 4 on both sides. You get negative 4, and of course, as we talked about earlier, that's the same as positive 3. Another way to look at it is if you put 3 right here, 3 plus 4 is 7. That's of course congruent to 0 mod 7. So x is congruent to 3 mod 7. And of course, add 2 on both sides, x is congruent to 2 mod 7. And with that, of course, we have the same answer. This is much more fun because you have to think about how you can make things factorable, right? That's really cool. If you have a quadratic congruence that's solvable, if it does have solutions, maybe you can just somehow change the coefficients or the constant term to make it factorable and then make it work. Okay, if you guys like the question that we just did, then I think you also like brilliant.work because this right here, it's an interactive learning website that focuses on problem solving and deep understanding, and they have a lot of courses to choose from in math and science. And now they have this new feature called the daily challenges, and you know the best way to learn is by practice, right? So they have this right here for you guys. And let me show you guys the question that I want to show you guys today. What makes squares a little odd? And be sure you guys download the app so that way you guys can do these questions on the go, right? Anyway, we are comparing this to sum. And of course, you have three options. I will leave this to you guys. You guys can just come here and sign up for a free account so that way you guys can keep track of your progress. And after you guys finish this question, be sure you guys go right here for the quizzes so you can do a lot more. And notice this right here is for math competition fundamentals. And if you're interested to sign up for the annual premium subscription, be sure you guys use the link brilliant.work/blackpenrepent because this way you guys can get a 20% discount for the annual premium subscription, which gives you the full access to all of their courses. And be sure you guys just come here and check it out. Thank you guys so much.
If you really want to use quadratic formula,
go ahead and plug in A being 1, B being 2, and C being negative 8, and work it out, and let me know if you guys have the answer or not. But anyway, this is it, and I think I will do more videos on this because I think it's a lot of fun. And if you guys are new to my channel, be sure to subscribe for more math-related content. Thank you guys so much, and as always, that's it.